Greetings everyone, today I am going to introduce you a new WAN 2.1 model which is called as FusionX. This model has become extremely popular recently. In addition, it also has LoRAs, so you can use it with your base model. I have made a lot of experimentation to find out the very best parameters for this new model and prepare one click to use and one click to download presets for you. With the model downloader application that we have, you will be able to download this model, import presets into the SwarmUI and directly use this model with the highest quality. This model only requires 8 steps to generate videos from text or images, and its quality is just mind-blowingly amazing. Additionally, I have prepared presets for FLUX dev model as well because this was getting asked of me. There is official FLUX dev model preset and there is 2x latent upscale preset. With our model downloader, you will be able to download the face restoration plus upscaler models. Then with applying the preset that I have developed, you will be able to generate amazing quality images. The 2x upscale will add huge realism, quality, details to your generations as you are seeing right now. Just look at these newly generated details in the image. It is just mind-blowingly amazing and it is super real. So if you are having issues to generate realistic images with FLUX and if you are struggling to upscale it properly, this is the tutorial that you were looking for. We are going to use SwarmUI and ComfyUI as a backend, and if you don't know how to install them, I already have an amazing tutorial here, so you can watch this. The link will be also in the description of the video. So this is the main link that you are going to use. You see the tutorial is also linked here. The link will be in the description of the video. First of all, download the latest SwarmUI model downloader zip file. Move it into your SwarmUI installation like this. Then right click and extract all. I will extract like this. Then move and overwrite all of the files in the main folder like this, replace. Then double click Windows Start Download Models app.bat file, more info run anyway. Pay attention to the version you are seeing here. It should be at least version 46. Always use the latest version. Click download bundles and you can download the FusionX FP16 bundle or FusionX FP8 bundle. Either of them is fine. When you click the download bundle, it will download all of the necessary models. But if you don't want to download new big models, what you can do, scroll down and you will see there are LoRa models. Click there, click various LoRAs and you will see that there is WAN 2.1 14 billion FusionX LoRa for image to video and text to video. You can click each one of them and all of the downloads will start with the maximum speed. You will see the queue here. Currently we have queue of 3. You can also watch the progress here. It will use your entire bandwidth to download. This downloader is extremely optimized and it uses the latest Hugging Face libraries, and I am downloading from Hugging Face, so they are super fast. Moreover, if you have previously downloaded, it will just skip that file, and if your download fails for any reason, it will try to resume the download. Alright, so all of the models have been downloaded. We can see from the logs and from the CMD window. So as a next step, what we need to do is just return back to your installation and use Windows update swarmui.bat file. This will update the SwarmUI to the latest version and start it. You see, automatically updated and now starting, and it is started. So how we are going to use these new models? To use them, first of all, we should have the presets imported. To import presets, you can delete your existing presets because I changed some of their names. But if you want to keep all of them, click import presets, click choose file, return back the installation folder and select Amazing SwarmUI presets version 1. Check this override existing presets and import. And it will import all of these best configuration presets. Then let's generate an example video. So first of all, I will click quick tools, reset params to default so that I will have the default parameters. Then which model we should use, select WAN 2.1 FusionX image to video, direct apply, and it will apply all of the settings. Now you see that it is selecting init image because the bug has been fixed and it has the init image creativity as 0. So click choose file, choose the image that you want to animate like this. Then select the model from here. Why? Because there is one important thing. To find the model, let's type image, or let's type Fusion X. It is easier. And select the Fusion X image to video and click res closest aspect ratio. You see the resolution is selected like this. This is wrong because this model has 96 resolution. So click this hamburger menu, edit metadata, set it as 906. But you can keep it as 640 if you want to generate at lower resolution. However, this is the native resolution, so change models and it will get fixed like this. Okay, we are ready. What else you can change? You can make the steps count 10. It works better with 10, but 8 is also sufficient. You can go to image to video settings and make sure that you have changed the model from here. This is not saved in the preset for some reason, or this may not be. So select this Fusion X image to video, and you need to set your frame count. So 16 frames is 1 second. So let's generate 49 frames. It is 3 seconds. But there is plus one, as you are seeing. And I can also apply RIFE frame interpolation to increase FPS to 32. Okay, that's it. I also need to type a prompt for animating this image. For this task, I have used O3 model. I just said write a single line detailed prompt. Okay, this is the prompt. It's written, copy paste it, but you can also write your prompt. And let's generate. I have RTX 5090, so let's monitor what's happening. MVI top. I have to be sure that it is using almost entire GPU watt. Otherwise, that means that it is using shared VRAM. And if it uses shared VRAM, it will be extremely slow. So I need to be sure that it is properly doing block swapping and it is using almost entire GPU. So far it is looking good, 460 watts. Okay, 100, this is bad. Let's see what happens. Okay, 150 watts. So currently there is a bug at somewhere because maybe I am using a lot of other stuff with the VRAM. So how can I fix this? I can restart and try again. But let's just wait a little bit more to be sure. We can also see from task manager. And shared VRAM usage is 500 megabytes. Okay, it is getting better. 300 watts, 320 watts. I am also recording a video, therefore it is also using some VRAM. So what can I do? It is still slow. I can go to server backends and I can change the reserve VRAM like 5 gigabytes. Okay, save. It will cancel the task. I need to wait for backends to be reloaded. This normally shouldn't happen to you. If you just restart your computer, do not run anything else, just run the SwarmUI, this shouldn't happen to you. But if it happens like me because of some other applications, you need to do same. Just click generate again and you got an error because we just restarted. It is fine. Let's see the watt usage. Okay, it is again definitely using shared VRAM. This is a bug in ComfyUI. I couldn't find the reason yet. If I restart my PC, it would get fixed, but I don't want to set up everything from again. So I will just wait for video to be generated. Then I will move to the next step of showing you tutorial, but you understand the logic. If this happens, that means that you should restart your computer. Do not open any other application. And you should try to get as many as watt usages. Okay guys, I have solved the problem of using shared VRAM. I have reinstalled my ComfyUI backend and I discovered that with image to video models currently, Sage Attention is broken. I have reported this error. It works with text to video and also text to image models. However, with image to video, it is broken currently. This is because of ComfyUI latest version probably, but now it is properly generating the video. It is using accurate amount of VRAM. The speed is very decent. Let me demonstrate you while I am recording a video. So the speed is around 20 seconds IT. It is for HD resolution. The resolution is 960 to 960. Okay, I have forgotten it, so I need to reset. Then the frame count is 49. So with these settings, this is the speed we are getting. Okay, this is 960 to 960 video. Now I am generating another one with accurate aspect ratio after I did set. So we will see it in a moment. Let's also see the speed. Yes, the speed is around same, 20 seconds IT right now on RTX 5090 while I am recording a video. And this is the VRAM usage currently. Okay, so the video has been generated. It only took 3 minutes. And let's see the quality. The quality is just amazing. The mind-blowing. You see the realism. You see the high definition. This is HD resolution. And this is the initial image we have used. It already has some mistakes anatomically and from other parts, but the quality of the generated video is just mind-blowingly amazing. With only 8 steps and it only took 3 minutes, I also applied RIFE 2x frame interpolation, so it is also looking very high FPS. So how do we use text-to-video model? To use the text-to-video model, click Quick Tools Reset Params to Default, then just use WAN 2.1 FusionX text to video direct apply, then I will just type it, and I don't need to type anything else. But if you want to set RIFE frame interpolation, you need to go to the text to video and enable it from here. You can also change the number of frames from here, and let's see the difference. By the way, we also need to select the model, so interrupt, and let's change it to text to video model from here and generate, and that's it. It will load text to video model right now, then it will start the generation. Okay, text to video generation started. The speed is looking almost same, decent speed, like 20 second IT. By the way, I am using FP16 version of the model. Therefore, it requires some significant amount of block swapping. It is not fitting into the VRAM. You can also use FP8 version if you don't have a powerful GPU and a lot of RAM. But this may yield better quality compared to FP8 version. Okay, so text to video has been completed. This is text to video generation. It is pretty good, pretty decent, but image to video yields better results. If you ask my opinion, you can control more, but it is working. How about if you want to use LoRa? It is exactly same. Instead of this model, you need to select base 1.2.1 model. You can use GGUF or other variants as in the other videos. For example, you can select 1.2.1 text to video GGUF, and from the LoRAs, all you need to do is just select 1.2.1 text to video FusionX LoRa, and you can change its strength, its scale, its power from here. Let's try as a default. Let's also try with the same seed and see if there will be significant difference or not. Okay, let's generate. Okay, we got the output with LoRa as well, and the results are astonishingly similar. You see, this is with LoRa almost same, and this is the base model. I think both of them is looking amazing. Okay, now as a next step, I am going to show you how to use FLUX presets and also how to upscale. So open back our Windows Start Download Models app.bat file. You can download the FLUX bundle from here. You see FLUX Models bundle. Download it if you are lacking that. And additionally, what you should download is, you will see that there is other models, image upscaling models. This is what I recommend. So click to download best upscaler models. These are image upscaling models. Moreover, download face segment masking models. These two are the extra models to the FLUX additionally that you need to download. Since I already have downloaded them, they are automatically downloaded. So quick tools reset params to default, then go to the models and let's select FLUX. So I have this model that I have trained myself, and go to the presets, and you see FLUX dev official preset. So direct apply, and all the parameters are set. So I'm going to use this prompt on the model that I have trained myself, and I will generate an image. This will generate default 1024 to 1024. The FLUX generation on RTX 5090 is already really fast. So without even using the Sage attention, let's see the speed. Okay, it is 2 IT per second, almost 1.8 IT per second. And I am using 16-bit precision, not even 8-bit precision. And it is getting generated very quickly. It is also going to do a face inpainting, which doubles the time that it takes. Okay, this is weird, but why it shows like this, but let's see. Interesting, we got an error with the face inpainting for a reason. Now I am generating without face inpainting, segmentation face inpainting. Oh, by the way, we can modify this prompt and use the default model of the SwarmUI. So let's try it. Segment, then it will ask us face. Then we can just type our prompt like photograph of OHWX man, and let's use the same seed. Okay, this is generated. This image doesn't require face inpainting, but let me show you. I'm just going to show you. Okay, it is going to generate. The automatic segmentation is determined from here. You see segment refining, you can decide the order. You can change the other parameters like segment blur, grove, oversize, threshold. Okay, after this it should automatically segment. I think it is using clip model for segmentation. Okay, let's see from the server logs what is happening. Yeah, it didn't show. Okay, it shows now. Yes, now it is accurately processing the segment. Yeah, it is working. Let's compare images from this to this. Yes, I can see that the face looking better right now. Yes, so how we are going to upscale, go to presets, and this time we are going to apply Flux Dev Official 2x Latent Upscaler Direct Apply. What it is going to do is it is just going to enable refine upscale and set these settings. This is the model that I prefer, and then let's hit generate. This will increase the time by 4 times because it's upscaling, and also when you upscale you usually don't need face inpainting. But let's see the result, and the upscale has been completed. Let's see the difference from this image to this image. It has a huge amount of quality difference. As you are seeing right now, it is looking way better, as you can see. Before ending this tutorial, I have one more thing to show you. I am working on ultimate video processing application. Let me demonstrate you how far it has come, and soon hopefully it will be published. Before publishing it, I am going to raise the bronze premium prices so you can subscribe right now. We have made so much changes, we have added so many new features. One of the new features we added is image-based upscalers, which are extremely fast. Hopefully see you in another tutorial video.